Hello everyone, today we are going to see velocity analysis of slider crank mechanism by using ICR method, that is instantaneous center of rotation. Instantaneous center of a moving body is that center which goes on changing from one instant to another. So by locating instantaneous centers of all the links in the mechanism, we can find out velocities of all the links in the mechanism. So let us consider an example of slider crank mechanism. A slider crank mechanism is as shown in figure. The crank of length 6 cm rotate at a uniform speed of 300 rpm. The length of connecting rod is 25 cm when the crank has turned by 30 degree from its IDC. Locate all ICRs and find angular velocity of the connecting rod and velocity of piston. So the dimensions of crank and connecting rod are given and also theta is given. So by considering these dimensions, we have to take some suitable scale and we have to draw configuration diagram. So first, let us draw a configuration diagram with some suitable scale. Then step number 1, to find total number of links and to give numbers to the link. So first we have to count total number of links. So link number 1. Now, whatever the fixed link in the mechanism, we have to give link number 1 to all the fixed links. Then link number 2 will be the crank, link number 3 will be the connecting rod, and link number 4 will be the piston. So total links in the mechanism are 4. Now let small n be the total number of links. Then capital N, that is total number of ICR, can be found by using formula n into n minus 1 upon 2. So by substituting n equal to 4, we'll get total number of ICR equal to 6. So we have to locate 6 ICRs. Now let us list down that 6 ICRs. Now ICR of link number 1 with link number 2 will be I12. ICR of link number 1 with link number 3 will be I13. And similarly with link number 4 will be I14. Now ICR of link number 2 with link number 3 will be I23. And with link number 4 will be I24. And ICR of link number 3 with link number 4 will be I34. So we'll have total ICRs I12, 13, 14, 23, 24 and 34. So out of these, ICR which circled, that is I12, 23, 34 and 14, these are fixed and permanent ICR which can be located by observation. While I13 and I24, these are called as the moving ICR, which has to be located by using Kale's theorem. Now let us see how to locate these ICRs. So step number 3, that is to locate ICR by observation, that is fixed and permanent ICR. Now for a link having turning motion, whenever their two links intersect, at that point the ICR will be located. That is, now link number 2 will have turning motion with respect to link number 1. So its ICR I12 will be located at the intersection of link number 1 and 2. So I12 will be at A. Similarly, link number 2 and link number 3 are having turning motion with respect to each other. So their ICR will be located at the intersection, that is at point B. So I23 will be at B. Now link number 3 is connected to link number 4 and will have turning motion. So its ICR I34 will be located at the joint of link number 3 and 4, that is at point C. Now link number 4 is a slider. So slider will have linear motion. So we can consider a part of a linear motion of a slider. That is, we will consider the slider is moving with a center at infinity. Then a part of a circle having radius at infinity will be approximately straight line. So ICR of the slider will be lies at the center of rotation, which is at infinity. So we'll draw a line perpendicular to the motion of the slider. So slider is moving horizontal. So draw a line vertical, which is perpendicular to motion of the slider. Then on that line at infinity, there will be I14. So I14 will be at infinity along a line perpendicular to the motion of the slider. So now we have located these ICRs by observation I12, 23, 34 and 14. Now the next step is to locate ICR by using Kennedy's theorem, that is moving ICR. So now let's see the procedure. Draw a circle of any radius. So I randomly draw a circle. On that circle, pick number of points equal to number of links. So we have 4 links, so we have to take 4 points anywhere on the circumference of a circle. So point 1, 2, 3 and 4. You can take these points at any distances on the circumference. Now, we have located I12, so join 12, that is I12. We have located I23, so join 23, that is I23. We have located I34, so join 34, that is I34. And also we have located I14, so join 14. So now we have joined the lines for which we have located the ICRs. Now remaining are I13 is remaining and I24 is remaining. So now let us see how to draw ICR I13. So join point 1 and 3 with a dotted line because that ICR has to be located. Now search two triangles which will have 13 as a common side. So see triangle 1, 2, 3 and triangle 1, 4, 3. Both these triangles will have 13 as a common side. So I13 will have common side with I12, 23 and I14, 34. Now Kennedy's theorem states that if three links will have motion with respect to each other. So there are three links 1, 2 and 3. So if three links have motion relative to each other, then their ICR lies in a straight line. Means I12, 23, 13 should be along one line and I34, 14, 13 should also be along a same line. It means that if you join a line joining I12, 23 and if you join I14, 34, then at the intersection of these two lines, you will get I13. So now let us see how to join. See, here is I12, 23. So join I12, 23 and extend. Then I14, 34. So here is I34 and here is I14. So the intersection of these two lines, that is line joining 12, 23 is this one. And line joining 1434 is this one. So at the intersection of these two lines, there is I13. Same way we have to locate I24. So now see, what are the two triangles for common with side 24? 1, 2, 4 and 2, 3, 4. So you will get for I24, you will get two sides of triangles are 1, 2, 1, 4. So this is 1, 2, 1, 4 and 2, 3, 3, 4. So what we have to do? You have to join 1, 2, 1, 4. So draw a line from 1, 2 and 1, 4. So now how to join a line from 1, 2, 2, 1, 4? Because 1, 2 is a point and 1, 4 is a line. So you have to shift this line parallel here. So whenever you have to take the intersection of ICR of a slider, just you have to shift that line of the slider ICR to the required point. So just shift this line parallel here. So this is a line of ICR joining 1, 2, 1, 4. And second is 2, 3, 3, 4. So 2, 3 is over here, 3, 4 is over here. So join a line and extend it. So these two lines intersect at this point. So this is your ICR I24. So like this, we have to join and get the intersection to get moving ICR. So this is the method to locate moving ICR by Kennedy's theorem. Now what is asked in example? To find angular velocity of link BC, that is omega 3. Now RPM of crank given 300 RPM. From that we can find out omega of crank, that is omega 2 equal to 2 pi n by 60, that is equal to 31.416 radian per second. Now there is an angular velocity ratio theorem. That is, you can take ratios of angular velocities of two links. So omega 3 upon omega 2 will be equal to distance of I12, 23 divided upon distance from I13, 23. So how to get this formula? So you have to take common ICR. So which is the common ICR for link number 2 and 3? I23. And you have to take ICR of omega 2 with respect to fixed link, that is I12. And ICR of link number 3 with respect to fixed link, that is I13. So that will give you the ratio for angular velocities. Now substitute omega 2, measure distance of I12 to 23, which you have located already. Measure the distance from I13 to 23, which also we have located already. Then you can find out omega 3, that is equal to 6.5907 radian per second. Then next is asked to find velocity of point C. Now velocity of point C can be found by considering C is on link number 3 or C is on link number 4. C is at the intersection of link number 3 and 4. So you can consider C as link number 3. Then in that case, V equal to R into omega. So that omega will be omega 3 and R will be the distance of ICR of fixed link to the distance of ICR of that two common link. Means C is on link number 3 as well as on link number 4. So take I3-4. And as we are taking omega of 3, you have to take ICR of link number 3 with respect to fixed link, that is I13. So you can get this formula. So now measure the distance of I13 to 3-4 into omega 3. That will give you velocity of point C. Now by using this kind of relation, you can find velocities of any point in a mechanism. So means by locating ICR of the mechanism, you can find linear velocity of any point and angular velocity of any link in the mechanism. Thank you.